Aaron Mullen.
And I'm Nick Cody, filling in for Chris Hemsworth. Get well soon, mate.
And this is 20 to 1. Tonight on an all-new 20 to 1.
Clickable hits that went global overnight.
Well done, the internet. From on-air blunders and rants.
So the audience are a bunch of hoes.
I admire his flair.
And viral stars without any dax.
Oh, I had nothing on Barbie jocks.
Retweet.
To social media's biggest heroes and villains.
Dude, get a room.
But what will be the most viral mega hit ever?
This is what the internet should be.
Tonight on 20 to 1, the viral sensations that conquered the world.
Videos that spread like Ebola, but don't make your eyes bleed quite so much.
Starting at number 20 is a man who is an expert in global affairs.
And yet, a total novice on the domestic front.
In 2017, the Korean Peninsula was in its usual state of crisis.
Well, today's development is the culmination of months of turmoil in Korean politics.
The BBC crossed live to expert Robert Kelly for his analysis.
But they accidentally captured a surprise invasion.
That this is a triumph of democracy. Scandals happen all the time. The question is, how do democracies respond to those scandals?
And what will it mean for the wider region? I think one of your children has just walked in.
Anyone who's had little kids, you know that kind of walk, that, I'm gonna have a bit of fun here.
Unaware of the serious stuff Dad was talking about, his four-year-old daughter Marion burst in.
She has swag like it's nobody's business.
And then the other one comes in on that roller thing, which is, they're very dangerous. It's like a Dalek. Doesn't go downstairs very well, does it?
And finally, in comes the wife.
My apologies.
Who did her best to get the interview back on track.
What is this going to be for the region?
My apologies.
The best thing about this clip is the wife crawling on the floor thinking, I might have got away with this.
But they didn't get away with it, waking up to find 6 million people had already seen the clip online.
It was massive, like millions and millions of views. It was on every TV station. It was on everybody's Twitter feed.
It is the interview which made headlines around the world for the most hilarious reason.
Let's play you a clip that you may have already seen. I mean, who hasn't?
No one cared about Korean blah, blah, blah anymore. It was all about how professionally Robert handled his kiddie crisis.
He could have laughed more. You know, it's nothing so serious.
My apologies.
He should have done what my dad would do. Been like, you Lyman kids! And I'm going. Don't make me come back there. I'm crossing to the bloody BBC!
But it was daughter Marion who became the breakout star.
The stylish four-year-old is setting the internet on fire.
She became an internet sensation.
If I had half of her confidence, I would take over the world.
Kid even got her own cartoon.
We must help Dad.
The BBC Dad clip went on to clock up 28 million views on YouTube and another 100 million on Facebook.
Out of all the years of upstanding journalism, I really enjoy that this is now the BBC's most viewed video.
My apologies.
Let this be a lesson. If you're gonna have kids and then you're gonna do live TV, invest in a good cage.
Rad dudes doing parkour pretty much guarantee awesome viral fails.
What's up, sir? We're gonna ride till
we fall. But there's one extreme tweet we don't want to see slip.
This 25-year-old who goes by the name of Oleg Cricket.
Stop it. Stop mucking around. He's mucking around is what he's doing.
What is wrong with him?
Why are you doing that? Why are you on the buildings? Why do you not have a harness? Why is there no parachute? Why? Just why?
I'm okay with heights. I'm not okay with this.
Jobs for Vanilla Ice impersonators are limited in his native Siberia, so Oleg moved to the West to make videos that had put adult nappies to the test.
Seriously, when he's jumping from like one tall building to another, or even just on the ledge of a tall building and the camera pans down, my stomach kind of flipped.
Watching those videos made me feel ill.
But the internet went fully sick for Oleg, with his vom-inducing stunts going massively viral.
He's doing this really cool stuff, but he's undermining it because he's got like a GoPro on his head, and that automatically makes you look like a dick.
No Pro or No, Oleg's racked up 43 million views.
For dumb stuff, like using a skyscraper as a slippery dip.
I hope he lasts.
I hope you fall off.
He is what my grandmother would call a temporary human.
After risking his life, Oleg risked his rep with the most extreme thing an extreme dude can do, launching a YouTube lifestyle channel.
No, there's nothing that he does that lends me to believe that he would be a spokesperson to endorse a product. Ben, you're making me
to care about. Actually, big brands line up to throw money at Oleg, including, of course, Red Bull.
Well, that's their thing, isn't their slogan, Red Bull gives you wings? I mean, in his case, he's certainly going to want to hope so.
I need a new pair of pants after watching that.
You should go see Alex from Target.
Who's Alex from Target?
The teenager who became a global heartthrob faster than you can scan a pair of jocks.
In America, Target spends big bucks on their brand, but no ad touched as many people as a single photo of this guy. Tonight's number 18, Alex from Target.
Alex from Target is one of the creepiest things ever.
Yeah, creepy, but really cute too, because in 2014, 16-year-old Alex LaBeouf was working as a Texas Target bag boy when a 21-year-old woman snapped his photo and uploaded it onto the internet.
Imagine if it was the other way around though, and it was a 21-year-old dude taking a photo of a 16-year-old woman working at a Target.
Yeah, you make a good point, but it was a more innocent time. Teenage girls on Twitter didn't care, and before Alex knew it, he was famous around the world.
His phone broke from the notifications. He got over 10,000 messages. I didn't even know 10,000 people that could possibly message me.
One day, just 147 people interested in you.
The next day, he's got a million Twitter followers and he's on Ellen DeGeneres, having no idea what to say or what to do.
Ellen, poor Ellen, I can see just in her eyes, she's like, I am now officially dead inside that it has come to this, that I am interviewing Alex from Target.
Do you sing? Do you have any other talent? We should take advantage of this.
I mean, I can apparently bag groceries pretty well.
Oh, okay.
He might not have been talking goodly, but his handsomosity saw him in hot demand in La La Land.
Where is he now? What happened to him? Is he dead? Is that why we're talking about him? Did he die?
Not quite, but after a fallout with his manager, Alex from Target tried to rebrand himself.
As bodybuilding Alex Lee World.
I hear you're a massive social force to be reckoned with.
I am. Watch out.
Who knew? All you had to do was work in a retail job, don't try that hard, and then suddenly you're on Ellen. Aim low. You'll never be disappointed.
Eurovision. It's like being on psychedelics inside the mind of Lady Gaga.
It's huge. It's a huge TV show where people sing hopefully terrible songs with bad explosions and weird things going on.
But in 2015, all that OTT spectacle was eclipsed by this guy, Swedish sign language interpreter Tommy Kran. We are the heroes of our time.
Tommy is just loving it. It's like watching kittens and rainbows make out with each other.
He got sacked from his last job. Apparently, he got a bit handsy.
Making his Euro debut, Tommy first brought the magic of the world's craziest Estedford to deaf viewers on Swedish TV.
Of course fans of Eurovision are deaf. It all makes sense now. I was watching it with the sound up, like a bloody fool.
You're deaf, you can see the person performing, but you don't know what the song's like. But when he's dancing, you get the beat, you get the feeling. And he was all this.
Tommy's enthusiasm went viral and won him fans worldwide.
Why didn't he win Eurovision? He was much more entertaining than any of the things on stage.
I mean, not only inclusive, but fabulous.
He's somehow able to be the gayest thing at Eurovision. Do you know how hard that is? Like, I've had sex with men, and that was less gay than Eurovision.
Gay or straight, Tommy racked up over 5 million YouTube views.
How does it feel to be the most famous sign language interpreter in the world at the moment?
It's crazy.
We've had some pretty unlikely viral superstars, but
This guy is the most unlikely viral superstar ever.
That means awesome in sign language.
While some viral hits make stars...
That dog scares the shit out of me.
...others make monsters.
Well done, the internet. But which viral mega hit will be tonight's biggest?
I was rooting for you! We were all rooting for you!
I reckon I watched that once a week.
Welcome back. We are counting down 20 to 1 viral mega hits.
At number 16, it's the dad who made his kids famous by chucking them off buildings, letting them play with explosives, and tossing them in molten lava, as you do.
And if child services ever get a hold of these videos, he's in big trouble. Hang on, this isn't so bad.
Let's see you, buddy.
Oi, you're paying for that, you little bastard.
Back in 2014, American visual effects whiz Daniel Hashimoto took time off working on films like Kung Fu Panda 2 and Shrek Forever to use his skills to bring the imagination of his three-year-old son to life.
Let's go!
And put every other parent to shame.
I got it.
As a kid, this is what dreams are made of.
I just love it.
I don't want my son to see them because then he's going to have really high expectations on his dad and me, and we are shit with computers.
You forgot your lunch!
The thing is that people go, oh, I see the best dad ever. No, he's not. So do you spend time with your kids? Well, apart from filming him for 5 minutes today, no, I'm in the computer. I can't even remember his name. What's his name again?
James, or Action Movie Kid as he's known to his fans around the world, may be pint-sized, but he's clocked up 400 million views on his YouTube channel to become a viral mega-sensation.
He should get that looked at.
He is probably the envy of every child anywhere in the world.
Oh my gosh, how did he film that one?
I need to learn how to do that.
How confusing for that child when he gets to about 15 and he looks back at all these movies and he's like, I do not remember going through a portal.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
I must have been.
Being one of the most famous toddlers on the planet, James has now fronted ads for some of the world's biggest brands.
Come on, let's play.
Bagged himself a book deal.
It's amazing.
And even has a movie in development.
He's going to be the Michael Jackson of YouTube. He's going to go right down the gurgler and things. It's going to happen.
But for the time being, Action Movie Kid is cashing in on his fame while Dad does all the hard work.
He's just avoiding his kid. I'm on to you, mate. I know. I've got three.
For too bloody long, cats have ruled the internet while man's best friend has been named and shamed.
But one talented French bulldog has changed all of that.
Meet Walter, the singing dog.
You cannot keep interrupting. No, I'm having...
I love Walter. I just love Walter.
We've all had a drunk friend, we're trying to get into a cab, that's making that noise like the...
That dog scares the shit out of me.
In 2018, Texan Amber Martin started uploading vids of her doggy Diva on Instagram. And so far, Walter's dulcet tones have reached 26 million ears.
Take a look at this adorable French bulldog.
Walter the Frenchie.
But this dog named Walter prefers to sing.
Well, look, it's one of those things where it goes, he sings, does he?
What do you mean, does he? Fans have compared him to some of the greatest singers of all time, like the one and only Whitney Houston.
I wonder if there was someone at the mixing desk having a bit of a fiddle there with Walter's vocals.
On the back of Walter's fame, owner Amber quit her job to become his full-time mummager and make a mozza flogging merch.
My pet does nothing, nothing. Can't sing, can't dance, doesn't look grumpy, doesn't look happy. Just sits here and licks its own genitals. I mean, that's fantastic, don't we all wish, but, you know, it's not unique.
I'd probably sing that high too if I'd had the sniff.
Our number 14 viral mega hit introduced the world to an Aussie master of mixed martial arts.
Yeah, martial arts mixed with a complete lack of skill. In 2018, Melbourne was supposedly gripped by a crime wave.
And A Current Affair was there to talk to the city's very own Avengers.
You threaten my family, I'll tear you apart. I'll bury you.
These local vigilantes were going to fight back with whatever was at hand.
Baseball bats, nail guns, homemade machine guns.
And nunchucks. James Reed, a.k.a. Nunchuck Man, a.k.a. Dead Set Legend, stole the show by demonstrating how he'd stop a home intruder.
I wouldn't want to go up against him. He's got some skills.
He's like the Chuck Norris of Victoria. Woof, woof, woof.
Gut Chuck, when that shirt lifted up in the most inappropriate time, I mean, Raphael, eat your heart out.
Nunchuck Man got a million views in 6 hours on social media, taking him all the way to
Frankston Magistrates Court. Yep, the man who went viral for having nunchucks was arrested for having nunchucks.
What, nunchucks are illegal?
Poor fella. I feel sorry for him. Is he doing time?
No time in the slammer, but he did cop a 12-month suspended sentence.
And was ordered to hang up his nunchucks for good.
Who else is going to protect the neighbourhood if they take away his nunchucks? The police? Probably.
Introducing the Slut Guard.
From satirical sex gear and itchy lady bits.
Yeah, it's just a case of thrashing your coochie-coo.
To fallopian dystopia and millennial parodies. Cheeky Aussie trio Sketchy are models turned comedians. Lana Kington, Madison Lloyd and Shaylee Shackelford.
And because, like Zoolander, they're so incredibly good-looking, the girls had to overcome initial doubts.
But as a fellow model myself and a good-looking person, we have to live with that.
We kind of put together a sketch show originally that we wanted to kind of sell out to a TV network and no one was buying. And then we started doing some videos in the car when we ran out of money.
And in 2015, when they mimed to one of the greatest songs ever, they became viral megastars.
While it seems innocent, Bohemian Cassidy's subtle raunch saw it clock up over 30 million views on YouTube.
They got a wanking gag, finger to the head, boob grabbing. I mean, that's edgy.
And 30 million views meant Ellen came calling.
You have earrings here.
I don't remember anything, yeah. Just staring into her eyes and going, wow.
Sketchy followed up with more car vids and comic skits.
He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
And before they knew it, that cracked 260 million views.
They're beautiful and they're a viral sensation. And I just wanted to say all the best, girls, and I'm not bitter at all. So well done.
If Marcel Marceau was a hot Australian chick, he would have been even bigger.
These girls are funny, they're energetic, they're beautiful, they've got great hair. Basically stolen my entire act.
Still to come, the stunt that had Jaws on the floor.
He is tucking amazing.
But which viral mega hit will score tonight's biggest bullseye?
But I had nothing on bar me jocks.
Do I want to see it? No. But yes.
Tonight's number 12 is the chef who...
Oh, my God, yes! That guy and the...
Who is this lunatic?
The condiment-sprinkling lunatic is...
Salt Bae. Huge fan of his.
So is the rest of the world since January 2017, when Nusret Goce, a steakhouse chef from Turkey, posted this video.
Within 48 hours, his flamboyant salt sprinkle had 2.4 million views. And social media fans hailed him as Salt Bae.
He does a very LGBT-friendly, how shall I say, sprinkle.
Is that the move? I think that's the move.
Shake it like a salt shaker.
33 million views followed, and Salt Bae now has 14 restaurants in 4 countries, and even one in New York.
Insta fame helped his business in a major way.
They attract celebrities like Leo DiCaprio, the Beckhams, and white powder-loving Diego Maradona.
Salt Bae's signature move has become a thing.
He's popular, but he divides people for heaps of reasons.
Overpriced, bad quality service. We paid $2,000 for nothing.
According to the experts, the food's rubbish, but you're not going there for the food, you're going there for the forearm flourish.
And no one's a fan of the way Salt Bae plays with his food.
Dude, get a room.
He's got some interesting tendencies, and I'm glad that he's taking it out on food instead of people.
He's a little bit Silence of the Lambs, isn't he?
At least he's showing a bit of respect to the animal. I know he's slapping it and teasing it. He's giving it a bit of something.
Unfortunately, not all Salt Bae's customers get to have their meat molested by the Bae himself.
I actually went to his restaurant in Istanbul in Turkey. He wasn't there. I was so disappointed.
It's like if you go to a Gordon Ramsay restaurant, unless he's telling you to right off, then it's not really worth going to his restaurant, is it?
I wonder if that works with chicken salt.
Our next salty star went viral after challenging an audience to fight her in the car park.
Classy.
And soon rose to fame despite adding to her criminal record.
And by criminal record, we mean her first album.
I'm going to have to ask you to leave. You are being inappropriate.
Dr. Phil is America's favourite fake TV doctor who specialises in dealing with dysfunctional idiots.
I'm liberating over 70 billion pigs.
But he was left gobsmacked by trash-talking teen Danielle Bogoli.
And all these hoes laughing like something funny.
Whose mother brought her on because, well, here's the show title.
I want to give up my car-stealing, knife-wielding, twerking 13-year-old daughter who tried to frame me for a crime.
I steal cars. I steal her credit card. I ain't gonna lie. There's no reason to lie. Everybody know already.
Danielle took a lot of stuff, but one thing she wasn't gonna take, any crap from Dr. Phil.
Catch me outside. How about that?
Huh?
Catch me outside. How about that?
Hang on. What did she say?
Catch me outside. How about that?
Catch me outside. How about that?
Catch her outside and she'll go outside and do what she has to do.
It's millennial speak, Dr. Phil. Get with the times, Mary.
She's clearly a little isn't she?
Catch me outside, how about that?
No one cared what Dr. Phil had to say after that because Danielle's catchphrase went viral.
The clip was watched over 50 million times on YouTube, and that was just the start.
My 98-year-old alcoholic mother, Maggie, told me about the Catch Me Outside girl.
She used her Insta fame to help her become a bona fide rapper. She now goes by Bad Baby.
YJ's
Bad Baby bagged a multi-million dollar music contract with a major record label. And her videos have been seen nearly 1 billion times.
She's now a 15-year-old worth $1.2 million.
What?
She also scored a Billboard Awards nomination alongside Nicki Minaj and Cardi B. How about that?
She does deserve her fame, and I hope she enjoys everyone coming up to her, yelling her catchphrase back in her face at 6 a.m. at the airport when she's hungover, going, "Catch me outside, how about that?"
Here's a catchphrase, "Shut up, you little shit, and be nice to your mum."
They're the soundtrack to Australia, up there with the chirp of cicadas and burnouts on a summer's day.
But only one Aussie sound has ever become a viral mega hit.
Barnsley!
I think his scream is one of the greatest things we've ever produced. I always put it on par with the Goombag.
It's so primal. A lot of babies would have been made to that scream.
But it wasn't until Our Jimmy became a Godzilla-sized screaming ghost cowboy in a music vid that he became world famous.
The 2017 clip for Kieran J. Callanan's song Big Enough racked up 34 million views.
I thought the music video was great, and then I saw the meme from Jurassic Park, and I'm like, that's where it should be.
Jurassic Park was just the start. It then took on a life of its own with fans across the world remixing Jimmy into Game of Thrones, Anchorman, the old Star Wars, and the new.
And pretty much every other show, game or movie you can think of.
He's got a beautiful scream. You get lifted off the floor a bit.
Like he was taking the piss of his own iconic sound in many ways. He's a legend.
But only one idiot didn't get in on the fun. American talk show host Jimmy Fallon.
Yeah. All right, stop. That's...
You sang that, didn't you?
No, it's not me doing that. All that scream, and he really just kept going higher and higher.
How dare you, Jimmy Fallon? How dare you? I mean, yeah, the song isn't that great, but he's double the Jimmy you will ever be.
Still to come, the bad behaviour that became a global super me.
Well done, the internet. She looked good and crazy.
But which viral mega hit will rule them all?
I was furious.
This is a traditional Japanese tea ceremony, which is all about balancing harmony and tranquility.
And this is Japanese Teacup Man, who's all about balancing things on his knob.
In 2017, ballsy performer Kazuhisa Okuza went viral with his teacup-based stunts.
I have a question. How does Teacup Man do it?
I don't know where he puts his gentleman junk, but he is tucking amazing.
Unless he's pushed it under his leg.
I think he's taping the tea bag down.
I don't know that I would have a cup of tea with him afterwards, though. That would be gross. A little bit of a sip, find a pube in the cup. Blech.
Since his first upload, Japanese Teacup Man has snagged over 74 million views.
The best part about the Teacup Man is, apart from the fascination of what is actually there, is the...
I don't think the pointing's necessary. I think we know what we're looking at.
I have a sum total of zero dick tricks.
Japanese Teacup Man was so popular, he went on to Britain's Got Talent, and his act touched people everywhere. Japanese Teacup Man was tossed off BGT before the grand finale, but his future's pretty bright.
He could get so many endorsements out of that, like Lipton's and... That's about it.
Yeah, he could work at a five-star hotel just delivering breakfast. Tea, you roll him over, toast pops out. Perfect.
I'm just glad he doesn't drink macchiatos.
Our number 8 viral mega hit stars a Hollywood reporter who's great at remembering names.
Yeah, just really, really bad at remembering who they belong to.
This is a tasty burger.
This is Samuel L. Jackson. But this isn't Samuel L. Jackson in a 2014 Super Bowl ad for Kia. It's the Matrix star, Lawrence Fishburne.
Everyone knows that. Well, except for American entertainment reporter Sam Rubin, who crossed to Jackson in 2014 to talk about his new movie, RoboCop.
The Super Bowl commercial, did you get a lot of reaction to that Super Bowl commercial?
What Super Bowl commercial?
You know what? I've admit my mistake.
You're as crazy as the people on Twitter.
Right.
I'm not Lawrence Fishburne.
Awkward.
Really? Come on.
I've literally talked to everybody. So you're entitled to one mistake.
Doesn't you're the mind. Entertainment reporter right. for this station?
Blog.
And you don't know the difference between me and Lawrence Fishburne?
My mistake.
That must be a very short line for your job.
I'll say it. He had me on live television and he would not let me go. Let's talk about RoboCop.
Oh, hell no.
Lawrence Fishburne and Samuel L. Jackson don't look alike. It's just that they're black. It's really awkward.
How does an entertainment reporter get that wrong? They have one job. Read a new weekly.
And you tried to laugh it off. No, mate. You made a bit of a boo-boo.
We don't all look alike.
You're
exactly
right.
All black and famous.
You are
all
guilty.
This was 3.5 minutes of, oh my God.
Sam Rubin's awkward moment went massively viral, racking up millions of views and made headlines everywhere.
I was a bit disappointed with Sam. Not one mother effing F-bomb.
But he went one better.
I'm not Lawrence Fishburne.
I can relate. I've been mistaken for heaps of people. Waleed Ali, Akmal.
Yeah. I get Rene Lawrence.
from the Bali Nine.
Peter Hellyer.
If I sit on a park bench for long enough, people think that I'm Ronald McDonald.
Will Anderson.
On the more obscure lines, I've also had Katie Lang.
Language.
The internet loves Australian politicians when they
tote guns,
play dress-ups,
or do anything with vegetables.
But only one Aussie polly's face has seen him rise to become a viral mega hit.
Peter Dutton, just like so charismatic, so sexy.
Pete got his first taste of internet infamy when an off-mic joke about climate change went viral.
He's got a fantastic sense of humour.
Peter Dutton's got one of those smiles that only the mother of a serial killer could love.
But that was nothing compared to the moment Pete was snapped in an incredibly unflattering light as he stepped up to a press conference podium.
The light makes him look like he's some sort of evil overlord.
That photo coming out of the shadows? Be perfect for Grindr.
She must use that app where you take a photo of someone, it shows what their souls look like.
After seeing the photo, Pete's people demanded the journalist take the pic off Twitter.
The internet's gone. Not only are we not going to take it down, we're going to make it go everywhere. And sure enough, memes and photoshops of Peter Dutton in various situations. Yeah!
The internet went wild trying to decide who Pete looked like.
Personally, I'm surprised that he even had time to be at a press conference. Surely he's spending most of his time locking up children and trying to kill Harry Potter.
The photo and the meme only work of him as a supervillain because he acts so villainously.
He should just embrace it and use it as a Christmas card. If I was him, I'd be using it as my passport photo. I'd be using it as my driver's license photo. It's just a gift that keeps on giving, really.
Coming up, the most viral spit-swapping session ever.
That was a good one. I'm sorry.
I was furious.
But which viral moment will be tonight's biggest hit?
See ya later!
This here is the awkward moment.
Can you turn off the lights?
You have nice eyes.
Thank you.
How are you?
Elizabeth.
How are you?
Nice to
Shall
meet
we make
you.
Out?
Absolutely.
Hey, Erin.
Come on.
Are we on SBS now?
No, Nick, still on Nine. This pretentious black and white art film from 2014 featuring a bunch of LA-based strangers pashing was a viral mega hit known as First Kiss.
So are we doing this now?
Yeah,
oh, yeah.
I love this. Why wouldn't you love this? Didn't people love this?
I smelled a rat the minute I watched that. Number one, why is everyone good looking? Oh, shot in this beautiful little filter. Oh, so soft.
That was a good one. I'm sorry.
Not everyone had such a good BS radar. More than 130 million romantics fell in love with First Kiss. But then the fairy tale was over.
Oh, damn, another ad. Bugger. Everything's an ad.
That's right. It was an ad for American clothing company Wren. And that got some people very angry.
I was furious.
As much as we might have felt ripped off, the company name was there all the time in black and white.
This ad is so pretentious and awful that it had to be parodied.
There was First Zombie Kiss.
Snapper.
First Sniff and First Raspberries.
Hey, they've stolen our pre-show warmer.
But the one that had us on the edge of our seats was First, Nick, you take this.
Erin?
Toby?
First shit. First shit.
How can you be ready for life?
I've honestly never kissed anybody on the pot before.
People were taking the piss, but Wren had the last laugh, with sales up 14,000%.
So good for them. They made a viral video, everyone got fooled and everyone's pissed off. You ate it. You ate it up. Own it.
Our next viral megastar became famous by simply running down the street in his undies.
What? When I do that, I get arrested. And when he does it, he ends up on bloody TV.
Yeah, just blowing the froth off a couple.
Hoax. Is there anyone more Aussie?
Yep, Hawkey.
Anyone Aussier than Hawkey?
Warning.
Vegemite.
Anyone Aussier than Warnie?
Yep, Aussiest Aussie hero ever, Brisbane's Daniel McConnell.
I was in bed sleeping at 2 o'clock this morning. My wife comes in and says, someone ran into the shop. And I said, oh, what? All I had was my undies on, and I've walked out the front and I've seen the car smashed, and I've seen the bloke walking back to the car. And so I've walked outside and I said, oh, what are you doing, mate? Like, you can't be leaving the scene.
The moment he opened his mouth, I knew we were in for a good ride.
In 2016, Nine News reporter Jessica Millwood scored the interview of the century when Daniel told her how he'd chased down a crook.
So I jumped in my car and I started chasing him up the road, and then he went down a side street and then the police were coming.
He's so Aussie, isn't he? It's like the essence of Australia. Just someone's boiled it down, and whoop, there he is.
And it just made it for perfect morning television.
Dan's Aussie-ness was so Aussie, some people thought he couldn't be for real.
When I first saw it, I thought, is this a character? Is this Chris Lilley trialling a new character?
Oh, Danny. I mean, what an Australian hero. He's a real-life Captain Underpants.
The clip clocked up 35 million Facebook views worldwide.
5 million YouTube views.
And countless news headlines.
People overseas were thinking, is this what all Aussies are like?
That was beautiful to see Brisbane's own Kid Rock out there fighting the good fight.
He's the national treasure, a pot of Tui's gold.
And believe it or not, Daniel is a hit with the ladies.
You know, he's got 5 kids. That guy, so someone, I don't know who, finds him really sexy and can't stay off it.
I assumed that you couldn't be hot if you had no teeth. And then, I mean, I'm all turned around on that now. He's a tasty piece, isn't he?
Nah, he's a legend.
Oh, they're me jocks, they're me undies.
I was like, oh, yep, of course you were. You got 5 kids. Put some pants on.
Banks was one of the world's most successful supermodels.
Oh, I might need to sit down for a bit.
But while she's a perfect 10, she also knows how to turn the cray-cray up to 11.
And in 2005, when she totally lost the plot on her show America's Next Top Model,
Tyra created one of the world's first mega-viral videos.
Yells at this is because she loves me. I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you. How dare you?
Be quiet, Tiffany!
When Tyra starts spinning her head like that, like she's possessed by a demon, you know she's one serious supermodel.
Even Tyra knows when she's looking nuts, and she looked good and crazy.
I have never in my life yelled at a girl like this.
But since we're here, I'll keep going.
Tyra lost her mind at contestant Tiffany for not taking the show seriously enough.
I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you. How dare you?
I don't think she realises what rooting means in Australia.
When I hear rooting, I don't think shagging. I don't. I genuinely, well, now I will.
The rant went on.
You go to bed at night, you lay there, and you take responsibility for yourself.
And on.
You roll in your eyes and you act like this because you've heard it all before.
And on. To clock up over 9 million views on the new fangled YouTubes.
I remember Tyra Banks's rant was one of the first viral things I ever saw.
This clip is very important. If aliens land, the first thing we should do is just like show them that. It's like, this is the internet, this is mainly what we as humans are about.
Stop it!
It generated piss takes, merch, and an absolute ton of gifts.
And even 15 years on, it's still one of our fondest memories.
I reckon I watch that once a week. Nothing gets me more ready for a day than Tyra Banks screaming, "We were rooting for you."
I love it because it's one of those moments that just has lived on and on.
But did Tyra really spontaneously combust?
Tyra knew exactly what she was doing. She knows how to keep that show fresh.
It's actually very clever of her knowing that that would go viral, and we still talk about it today.
We were rooting for you! We were all rooting for you!
17 down, just 3 to go.
What will be the number one viral mega hit of all time?
Catch him, Daddy! Catch him!
This is 20 to 1 viral mega hits, and we are now into the top 3 most viral things not found in my gym bag.
Now, for a video to go viral, it needs to have that extra special something. So it could have perfect timing. It could have a big star.
Or it could just have a bat in a kitchen. That sounds wrong.
Mm.
Because they're bats. Catch him, Derry. Derry, catch him.
In the land of the leprechauns in 2017, the Fleming family came under bat attack.
Get him back out of the house.
Mom, will you get out?
Derry, will you catch him?
Catch him, Derry. Bigger towel, that's it. Catch him now, quick. God, Derry. Oh.
Old Dad Derry took up arms. Well, a towel, while son Tige stood behind a door, filmed everything and yelled a lot.
Catch him, Derry! Catch him!
Yes, yes, thank you for that, obvious man. Yes, that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to catch him.
These guys are playing Pokemon Go with high stakes. The rabies is involved in this.
You almost don't want him to catch the bat because the commentary from the son is so hilarious.
Did you get him? No, he's there. He's making a mockery out of you, mate.
Like Mum Maureen, with her nose pressed up against the glass door, the world couldn't look away.
Hashtag I'm with Maureen. I'd be fully behind the door just laughing at Derry.
And like the dog, we were pissing ourselves.
Dad, the dog's after peeing.
I did not see that coming.
Finally, success.
All that was left to do was mop up, post the video online, sit back and catch over 50 million views.
If that was in Australia, they'd just be like, get the bat, you dickhead. Get it. Hit it.
Derry, will you catch him? Oh, catch him, Derry.
The internet went nuts with remixes, while rabid fans celebrated with bat tats.
And in a twist, when Tide went on American TV, he turned out to be...
seriously hot.
I was going to say perfectly normal, but you're right.
And they look like a family who really love each other. Hate bats, but they really love each other.
Believe it or not, annoying buskers can actually become rich, famous and annoying megastars.
Just ask Ed Sheeran and Justin Bieber, which means we're probably going to be hearing a lot more from the yodeling Walmart kid.
I don't know no, what I do. All I do is
For once, you didn't see a scene at Walmart where someone forgot their pants or teeth.
Well, Lord, I thought I would cry.
In 2018, 11-year-old Mason Ramsey was filmed making the cat vomiting a hairball noise called yodeling in aisle J8 of his local Walmart.
Are we doing that now? Are we putting buskers into supermarkets? Because I just don't want to be standing there in the hygiene aisle, you know, deciding if I want wings or no wings, and then there's going to be some little kids singing next to me. I don't need that.
Mason was an instant viral megastar, clocking up over 20 million YouTube views in under a week.
It's the last time I scoff at anyone who's homeschooled.
The internet turned Mason Ramsey into a meme god.
I'd love to hear when you got the sweet last song, did she say goodbye?
He's had some amazing things happen to him since he went viral.
You always sing at Walmart?
That's the only store we've got. It's been like a month and a half, and here I am going to Ellen, Grand Ole Opry, Stagecoach.
He performed at the Coachella Music Festival.
Suddenly, it seemed every hipster was into yodeling.
Including former boy busker, Justin Bieber.
It's my destiny.
Got a Justin Bieber selfie?
Yeah.
Man, that's better than any advice he could have gave you, man.
The kid has a 40-date tour. He's doing better than Justin Bieber. See you, Justin.
You're a star now.
Yes.
There were more talk shows and a tour. He even got an Atlantic Records contract.
What? This kid's got an entourage and $1 million in his Dolomite account?
Getting more money.
He will piss that money up the wall.
What's he going to do when his voice breaks?
Hopefully shut up.
Our top spot tonight is taken by a bunch of guys who've made squillions.
By sitting around playing with their balls.
Ladies and gentlemen, at number one, we give you Dude Perfect.
Lucky shot. Nice. What the? Is that real?
Yep, it's all real. Before they were superstars, in 2009, Dude Perfect were just five guys fart-assing around in their Texas backyard.
It's Corey, Cody, Chase, Chad, other American names.
Close. meet Cody, Corey, Colby, Garrett, and Tyler.
These are American dudes.
American dudes whose videos have gone ballistic, racking up 7 billion views.
That is massive. That's one view for every person on Earth.
It's a new Guinness World Records.
Yes! And a sweet 27 Guinness World Records.
Dude Perfect is the most subscribed YouTube channel in America and ranked 8th in the world.
Everyone's into Dude Perfect. Even celebs like Serena Williams and Paul Rudd.
That sucks so bad.
And it really helps that one of them's a good-looking rooster.
Let's get started. Oreo Domino's with a little milky splash.
I wonder if their sponsor is Oreo. It is, and they clearly have money to burn.
So do a bunch of other big brands who pay big bucks to the dudes.
They haven't made millions of dollars. They've made tens of millions of dollars, and this is now a career.
What a way to earn a living, these blokes.
Dude, it's perfect.
Welcome to Ping Pong Trick Shots.
Or is it?
No!
You only saw it when it worked. I want to see the outtakes.
They just keep on going until they get it right. And when they get it right, it goes viral.
Whether they dunk, slam, thwack, or impale,
everything the Dude Perfect dudes do gets squillions of views.
Which is why they are tonight's number one, creators of the world's most mega viral hits.
I had no idea there were so many things you could do with a ping pong ball. Someone had to say it to me.
Dude Perfect's success is nothing short of amazing.
Yeah, all it took was years of dedication and hard work. Some guys have all the luck.
Well, that's it. We've reached the end of the 20 to 1 viral mega hit list.
Join us next time for another epic countdown.